Well, this one is a song about an unfortunate week I spent in Norway about 15 years ago. I went over to play with a dear friend of mine called Lillebjørn Nielsen, who's a very famous singer-songwriter in Norway. And the only trouble with Lillebjørn is that he kind of likes to have a drink. You know, it's a kind of, we'd rehearse for about 10 minutes, and he'd say, Andy, would you like to have a glass of wine? And I'd say, okay. Because I'm, you know, I'm a very obliging kind of person. And then he'd say, would you like, Andy, would you like another glass of wine? And eventually, that set the tone for the week. So we got away with it. We were there to play a gig in Telemark, and we were okay that day. But most of the rest of the time, we were kind of lulala all over the place. And when I got home, I was kind of pretty sick, and I languished in the bed groaning for about 4 or 5 days. And then I got up. I had to get up eventually, I thought. Otherwise, I'd just kind of be buried there. So I got up, and I thought, well, I'll write a song about my experiences in Norway with Lillebjørn. And I sat down and I couldn't remember one thing that I So I wrote this one. It's called Oslo. I drove to Oslo on a winter's day. The snow was falling from the grey sky. I got lost and could not find my way. I pulled into a handy lay-by. Then taking out my brand new mobile phone, telephoned my old friend Lillebjørn. I'll tell you what, we drank a lot until it came my time to leave us. We had a party in Lillebjørn's. The Akvavit was to my liking. Smoked meat and cracker bread. They said it came down from the Vikings. What's his name? Anyway, whatever his name was, he played some. We had a party in Lillebjørn's. The Akvavit was to my liking. Smoked meat and cracker bread. They said it came down from the Vikings. And Hunger played some vinaigrette and do. And Øystin played and sang, and very soon I was in good cheer, and I greatly fear when my turn came I was not able. When I awoke next afternoon, my head was pounding, senses reeling. I got up and staggered round the room. What were those creatures on the ceiling? And when I had my trousers halfway on, a dreadful thought came in my head. Oh, hang on a jiff, I can't remember if I'm getting up or going to bed. Well, in the Dubliner, we played a gig. Though we were all a bit hungover, a man got up and tried to dance a jig. It looked more like a bossa nova. I had some beers and I began to flirt, and very soon I was on blonde alert. You're too late, you know, 30 years or so. She laughed and went home to her man. In the kitchen we were feeling fine, spirits high and oh so cheery. The entertainment was provided by Lillebjørn's young daughter Siri. A drawing picture, she is very smart. She drew some clouds and said they're angel farts. We were impressed by her endlessness. It was a masterpiece quite clearly. I drove through Sweden in a snowstorm. What were those angels getting up to? From Gothenburg to Frederikshavn, I stood on deck and had a nice view. I drove through Denmark into Germany and went to see my old friend Gabby. Then the long road, oh, heavy load, until I came to Dublin City. So Lillebjørn, we'll meet again. We'll have some beers and then some more. Oh, we'll play Pinterbro, we'll play the Dream, and we'll play Yenta from Chicago. And if I go there on a winter trip, I'll make quite sure I get my heater fixed. I'll bring winter tires and a snow plow and double glazing for my window.